Ohio Governor John Kasich flew into Washington for this speech, and the governor is with me now, and good morning to you.
Bill.
Nice to see you in person. Why'd you come here?
Well, I've been a, you know, forever supporter of Israel, and I felt that this was an important speech, important to our country, important to our one of our greatest allies in the world. And look, I you know, I'm the governor of one of the most powerful states in the country, and I wanted to be here to lend my support.
Samantha Power yesterday said this: the USA will not allow Iran to obtain a nuclear weapon, period. Do you believe it?
Well, I'm very concerned about these negotiations. You know, Bill, the problem with negotiations, and I've been in a lot of them, is that sometimes you fall in love with your goal, and sometimes you're willing to do a lot of things to accommodate reaching that goal, and that gets to be a slippery slope and very nervous. So frankly, in this case, the Congress should have to ratify anything that this administration could reach agreement on, and I'm glad to hear that she said that. I don't know, that's the first time I've heard a statement like that out of the administration. Very dangerous. Let me tell you, the big problem is not just Iran getting a nuclear weapon, but for all of the people that watch here, you think about your kids and your grandchildren. What happens is the possibility of proliferation. This ends up in the hands of groups like Hamas, groups like Hezbollah. It's a very, very serious situation, and the proliferation of nuclear weapons, nuclear material, is something that the entire world has got to say we can't afford it.
Well, specifically for Bibi Netanyahu, America worries about security, he said yesterday. Israel worries about survival.
Yeah, well, look, they're right there. They're obviously, they live under an existential threat from Iran. I mean, Israel's not even on the map. If you go to Iran, you don't even see the country of Israel labeled. I mean, we know about all the rhetoric, but it's not just Iran. It is not just Israel that can find itself in the crosshairs. We can too, and we see all the things that are happening around the world. We scratch our heads when we look at ISIS and these other things. This is not the time to give a country that has been our sworn enemy a chance to have a nuclear weapon.
There are those on the other side who will argue that today could actually be injurious to the process, that it could hurt the process.
I think it's kind of, you mean our relationship?
Netanyahu's presence in his speech today.
I just think that's a silly conclusion. My opinion is you get bumps in the road. This is one we shouldn't have had to have had. But at the end of the day, our relationship with Israel is enduring. I mean, they're a democracy in the Middle East. They're our great ally. And this too shall pass.